week's episode of GVTV. I'm Meagan.
And I'm Drake.
And it's a new week, new episode, so let's get started.
It's hard to believe that there are only a few months left before graduation. Next up, college.
It would be nice to have some tips on how to make my college life a little better.
Well, let's head to Gabby to see some tips people have for you seniors and upcoming juniors.
Hey Green Valley, I'm Gabby. Have you guys ever wondered what tips you might need for college? Well, don't you worry, we've got you covered. Let's head out to some teachers and students to see what tips they have for you guys.
I'm here with AJ Montoya, and are you going to college?
No, I'm not.
Do you have any other plans?
I plan on going to the Marines.
Do you have any tips for anyone who may want to join the Marines?
Well, I'm still trying to get in shape myself, but get in shape and lift. And make sure your ASVAB scores are high so you can get the job you want.
All right, thank you. Do you plan on attending college?
Yes.
Where do you plan to go?
I'm planning to go to UMKC.
Do you have any tips for people that might want to get into UMKC?
Study hard.
Thank you.
I'm here with Miss Hannah. Did you go to college?
I did.
And where did you attend?
I went to the University of Missouri.
And did you like it?
I loved it. It was a really good school.
Do you have any tips for seniors who are wanting to go to college?
A couple pieces of advice. If you're going local, I would definitely try to make friends with people outside of your high school just because it's better to have a range of friends. College is weird. You need to study more than the night before a test since you only have like 2 tests per class. So you really want to make sure you study in advance. And then if you can get to know your teacher, it's always good so you get a little one-on-one help.
All right, well, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm here with Mr. Ball. Did you go to college?
I did go to college.
And where did you attend?
UMKC.
Did you like it?
I did like it. Yeah, that was a good fit.
And do you have any tips for seniors?
You kind of have to almost be your own advisor. You don't have really like a guidance counselor when you go to college. You will have an advisor who's supposed to be watching over your academic program for your study. But a lot of times at UMKC, I had 3 different academic advisors in 5 years. They rotate out or they leave. So you have to be very much kind of your own advocate, keep track of where you're at and keep track of your credits and that you're making progress toward graduation.
All right. Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow, I don't know about you guys, but I'm only a sophomore, and that helped me out. Thanks for tuning into this week's episode of GVTV. Now, back to you in the studio.
Well, there you go, juniors and seniors. Use those tips to make college life better. Thanks, Gabby.
This whole anchor thing kind of has me a little bit tired. I think I need a drink. Want me to get yours, too?
No, hey, wait. Do you know the lanyard policy?
I'm just going to get a drink.
It doesn't matter. If you don't have a lanyard, you can't leave, even though you want to go get a drink. Here, Ethan can tell you more.
Hey, GV. Ethan Netter here. I'm with Andre Hudgens. So, Andre, do you know what the lanyard policy is for?
So no intruders get in.
All right, and when are you supposed to have the lanyard around your neck?
At all times.
At all times? And do you know what the different colors are for? Thank you. Now I'm here with Trevor Jackson. So Trevor, do you know why we have the lanyards?
Yeah.
Do you know what they're for?
Yeah.
All right, what are they for?
They are there to identify you, and then also, depending on what level you have, you can have different privileges.
All right, and what are the different levels?
Red card, blue card, gold card, and platinum card.
All right, and what's the difference between a gold and a platinum card?
Platinum cards get to leave campus during lunch and then travel days and eagle time.
All right, thank you. Now I'm here with our principal, Mr. Plowman. So what exactly are the lanyards here for?
One of the big problems we have is as we've become a bigger school, when you have 1,200 kids and 150 adults in a building, you need some way of identifying who should be here and who shouldn't be here. We originally tried to create the lanyard policy so we have some way of identifying, are the people that are supposed to be in our building, are supposed to be in certain places, the right people. Let's say there's a student I don't know going down the hallway and they're causing trouble, or we see them steal something or hit somebody. We have the ability with that to rip that off. hey, here's who that kid is. It's a way to control who's in the hallway so it's not just a mess. And so that's why you put the policy in place. If you look at any business that has over 1,000 people in a building, if you can name me one that doesn't make people wear IDs, I'd like to find it. Same with schools that way.
All right, and when exactly are the students supposed to wear their lanyards?
So in a perfect world, you guys would do like Dr. Plowman is doing right now, have it around your neck at all times. I understand it clashes with outfits. There's reasons that you guys don't want to do it. So kind of our minimum requirement is if you're not in a classroom, not in the lunchroom, not somewhere specific like that, you are in the hallway, especially during class, you need to have that ID and the ID from your teacher. We've been real good about not just saying, I've been at a school where they said, you have to have it. The second you don't have it, they make you come up to the office and buy another one. We're not here to do that. We need you to wear it when you're out in the hallway so we know you're supposed to be out there and we know that you belong there. And I expect the same thing out of my teachers, out of my principals, etc.
All right, and I understand that there are multiple levels of lanyards. So what are those?
Are you talking about the gold card, platinum card, that kind of thing? So that's a privilege card for juniors and seniors, where if you have gold or platinum cards instead of the blue card, you have certain advantages, certain things you can do. We're looking at revamping that because there's a lot of people with gold or platinum cards that say, hey, there's not enough for me to do. So we're looking at having that be part of our card policy where you would have advanced privileges for having an advanced card due to your attendance, tardies, grades, etc.
All right, thank you.
Well, I have my lanyard now, but we don't have any time, so I'll just get some water later.
So, Drake, have you been keeping up with the election? How do you think things are going?
I'm not sure, but Carly, Eli, and Jake are talking to some students around the school to see what they had to say.
Hey GV, with the presidential campaign coming on, we want to know who you are supporting. Let's see what some of your fellow GV students have to say.
So who do you support in this year's presidential race?
I'm feeling the burn, Bernie Sanders.
Probably like Kanye, but I don't really like anyone now.
Well, it's gonna be whoever is the lead runner for the Republicans.
And why do you feel this way?
There's a lot of reasons. Could say the way I was raised, could say because I'm a Christian, and because I want somebody to win who's going to support the police and military.
He's not Donald Trump.
I'm just trying to feel the burn, honestly.
Mainly the fact he believes in more, he's more for education and universal health care.
Well, it's bound to be an exciting presidential race this year.
Currently, for the Republicans, Trump is in the lead with Cruz following, and for the Democrats, Clinton is leading with Sanders behind her.
Well, GV, that's all we have for you today. Thanks for tuning in. Back to you guys in the studio.
Well, the elections this year are definitely going to be interesting.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Anyways, I heard our neighbors at Sni-A-Bar have some exciting news.
What would that be?
I heard it has something to do with leadership.
Well, let's head out to Hannah, Kyle, and Sydney to learn more about Sni-A-Bar's Leadership Day and who contributes to this day of leadership.
Welcome to a special edition of GVTV. I'm Hannah Shackles.
I'm Kyle Clark.
And I'm Sydney Sully.
We are here to report breaking news about our neighbors at Sni-A-Bar Elementary.
We are blown away by this story. Seems like there's a lot of super leaders here, real superheroes.
That's right, Kyle. Super leaders that use their superpowers to create this magical school.
We're excited to find out more.
Let's head inside.
So what does it mean to be a leadership school?
A leadership school allows our students an opportunity to show their leadership skills, to find their voice and what leadership opportunities they have, whether that be school-wide, within their classroom, or just being the leader of themselves. And so a leadership school allows lots of opportunities for our children to find their voice.
Awesome. And why did Sni-A-Bar decide to become a leadership school?
Well, we saw a lot of great things happening at South Middle School here in Green Valley, and so we started to look into that process and what that would entail, and realized that that's exactly what we needed here at Sni-A-Bar to help our students to find their voice. And so in 2013, the staff spent an entire week learning during their summer vacation on their own time, coming in to grow themselves as leaders and to learn how to work with our students in that same way.
All right, thank you so much. I'm here with kindergartner Brielle. So Brielle, what is your favorite super habit?
Synergizing, because you get to help friends and partner up and to read and play.
Thank you. Took away the prophet's dream for a prophet on the street. Now she's
stronger than you know. A heart of steel starts to grow. Alright guys, now I'm here with Lincoln. So Lincoln, what is your favorite superpower and why?
Be proactive. Because, like, if you shake, it helps you not be reactive like Coke and water, because if you shake water, it will settle down quickly, but if you shake Coke, it will disappear.
All right, thank you.
I'm here with fifth grader Connor. So Connor, what legacy do you want to leave behind when you go to middle school?
The love for reading, because it's always been something that my friends know me for and something that I've always liked to do.
Okay, thank you. Third grader Canvas. So Canvas, what is your superpower?
Superpower is super smart.
And how do you use it to help others?
Use it to help others because I can help them, like, if they need help on like a certain subject in school, or help like tutor them and make them a little smarter.
Thank you. I'm here with Emerson. So Emerson, how has your experience with the 7 Habits helped you grow?
It helps me interact with more people, and I'm pretty sure it helps them interact too with more people.
All right, thank you. Leadership Day sounds super.
Thanks for tuning in. Now back to you in the studio.
Drake, what are you doing?
All this leadership talk has me bring out my inner Superman.
You are a super dork, that's for sure.
Whatever, you're just jealous. You can't be super like them.
Anyways, thanks, Hannah. Looks like they are doing a super job.
Before we head out, we'd like to congratulate a few of your fellow Eagles that are bringing in victories.
First, a huge shout out to Maverick Alexander and representing GV in the All-Star Duel by coming away with a 3-1 victory in the final seconds of his match.
Congrats on a well-achieved career, Maverick.
Finally, a big congratulations to the Lady Eagles with their victory against Bolivar Tuesday evening.
They are truly making Grand Valley history.
Hopefully you went to support them Tuesday, but if not, be sure to go and cheer on your team as they play St. Joe Benton in the state quarterfinals game.
The game is at the Independence Event Center Saturday at 6 p.m.
Well, it looks like that's all we have for this week's episode of GVTV.
Make sure to follow us on Instagram and Twitter at GVHS Eagle Media.
Thanks for tuning in. I'm Meagan.
I'm Drake, and we'll see you next week.